Trnava 2018 Višegrad Cup. Thursday and Friday greeted us with very windy weather, and the best 14 pilots waiting now for the first flyoff start really deserve to be on this start line. As you can see, the flags are still almost horizontal. And all the tapes are pointing the direction of the winds. So we have northerly winds, which makes the flying here very exciting. And this year additional complication is the fact that organizer is strictly enforcing the no-fly zone at any height over the camp. This caused some hot debates and few protests last evening, but they were not granted and things remained as they are. So despite the wind direction favors flying over the camp, pilots are not allowed to do so. So it will be interesting to see what kind of strategy will they choose for the flyoff. So now let's wait for the first start. So turns out there was some issue with the clock. They took something like 10 minutes to fix. But now it appears to be working. The organizer announced that if it dies again, they will continue manually. It's interesting to see that this year they have some issues with the equipment, which has been working perfectly in the past competitions for the past 5 years or so. But yesterday the table at the end of the line died. And it's still dead. Now the one on the organizer container is also having issues. Now let's see how the pilots will decide their strategy. My guess would be that the one that returns back to the point 3 times will win, similar as in Holich. So, as expected, majority is going downwind. Now some will pick the tree line over there, on the other side of the runway, which is promising generator of thermals in this wind. It looks like most of them are there. There are 4 that went upwind. And there's one in the middle. 2 actually. So let's now see how the people will manage to ride the wave from those trees. So the wind is picking up, as you've heard. Could be a sign that there's a bubble that just passed. So the issue with this decision is that you have to be confident that you will actually gain enough height to be able to return. And we've seen plenty of walks all the way to the end of the runway and even beyond that. And this runway is 2700 meters long, so this gives you an idea of how far people were flying today. So there are two guys still struggling. While I see six planes already high, and now interesting, the rest of the crowd appears to be joining them. Let's see if they manage as well. And this guy on the bottom obviously didn't find the good air. And as we've seen before, pilots are now coming down the runway to follow their planes. Also, observers need to provide all the help. So if the plane goes down somewhere in the distance, they want to be able to find it. This is an example of what we were looking at for the past 2 days. Trying to come home and not making it. And this tree line is something like 200 meters away from the starting point. So no score for this guy. So in my opinion, it's now better to be here, close to the line, being able to go home and score the points, and maybe hoping for another thermal to pass by, than being all the way down there. Following your model. No luck. But at least he has a model in one piece. Five minutes to go. This guy is now trying over my head. And I see some planes really high against the blue sky. Hard to track. So some people manage to gain enough height to be comfortable till the end, but that guy over there will still need to work. Looks like he's in luck. Or maybe not. So there are like 5 planes still in the air that I can see. No, 2 more above me, 3, 4. So looks like majority of the pilots did it till the end. Now the sky is full of whistling noises, because they need to lose like 400 meters of height in a minute and a half and get in a position to land. One minute to go. Quite a crowd. Okay, everyone landed in time. This is it for the first start, now let's wait for the second one. I expect now the second fly-off to be much the same. I move to the middle of the runway. That's about 30 seconds to start. Four, five going left. Over the hangars, trying to find something really low there. Don't know what they have seen before the start. But the wind has turned a bit. It's now more northeast. I see two more joining on the left side. So that means half of the planes are now into the sun from my standing point. The other seven must be behind me. Nothing really to brag about, the air over there. But given some patience, I hope they will make it. Some action behind me, really low now. So the siren you might have heard is the organizer attempt to signal to the pilots they are over the camp and that they have to turn away. So looks like this would be circling to the ground. No luck for these two guys this time. And 10 minutes to go. So looks like this time the better choice was the west side of the runway. Makes it difficult to observe because it's straight into the sun. But it looks like they will all make it. I see no one really in a difficult position now. I move to the landing spots. There's still like 4.5 minutes to go. And one plane from that crowd didn't make it. So it takes some bravery to fly far away into the blue sky and some skill to actually be able to follow your plane. Good pair of eyes as well. And this Ultima pilot is struggling for the every second he can now get. Not enough to do another circle. Better just get a good score for landing. The rest of the crowds now on final approach. Okay. Now let's wait for the third start. 3 minute break. So for orientation, the runway direction here is 1432. And as you can see, the wind is changing direction. So most of the time it was blowing from the north, like it is now, but there are periods in between where it's blowing down the runway. So this makes it slightly challenging for the pilots. You can either follow the wind or stay where they were thermals before. That's now something like 1 minute to start. And they're already observing what's happening out there. Up high. And my guess would be they will go into the sun again. So downwind. Which means forward, across the hangars and to the left. Four are now going to the left. Some went immediately downwind and behind me. And two of them are still trying their luck on the tree line. There's one really high there, trying to play it safe, apparently. Could be that he already has good score from the previous two flights. So now let's see what these three guys will do. So these three guys are now in actually good position. So the interesting thing now is happening again in the sun. Okay, this looks like it will be a penalty if that guy doesn't manage to fly around the camp somehow. But better a penalty than the model in one piece than blind landing behind the camp. Another one really low. Following the same logic. Ten minutes for me. And there's now one more over my head. So the wind really died down now, and I guess most of the planes in the air are still full of ballast, which limits the pilot's ability to pick on weak thermals. But this guy is managing it. Every second now counts. The other one is now over the camp. And as you can see, this is quite close to the ground. So he gave up. have to see where's the rest of the crowd. Directly above me. They need to make something like 5 minutes still. So it's not going down, but it's not going up either. And the rest of the crowd is, whoa, piling up far away. So this takes for some really precise and patient flying, working this weak lift, fighting for time. Five minutes to go. Looks like he gained something. And now he's slowly joining the rest of the flock, which is at safe heights for those 5 minutes. So looks like they will now all make it, and I'll move back to the landing points. Seconds. Low approach. Very nice. No collisions, no reflies. I like that. Now let's wait for the results.